So let's talk a little bit about exponential functions in general and what their graphs look like. So here we have one possibility, which is if b is larger than 1, we would expect our graph to be increasing and concave up. It will have a domain of negative infinity to infinity and a range of 0 to infinity, not including 0, because there's nothing we can put in for x that will give us an output of 0 or a negative number. So we do have a restricted range for exponential functions. It's both increasing and continuous from negative infinity to infinity, so it's always increasing. And it actually has a horizontal asymptote. This is the first time we've seen one of these, but it levels off at the x-axis. So in this case, b would be what we call a growth factor. So if b is larger than 1, the base is larger than 1, it's a growth factor. So that's when b is greater than 1. Now, for to be an exponential function, b only has to be greater than 0. So what about if b is in between 0 and 1? Can b be 1? Well, if b is actually equal to 1, then we're repeatedly multiplying by 1, and we just have a constant function. But let's talk about the case where it's between 0 and 1. Then we have what's called exponential decay. Notice that the graph still has the same form, except now it's decreasing, but it is still concave up, so it still has that increasing rate of change. As long as our initial value is positive, which will be most of the cases in this course, we are going to have a concave up graph for exponential function. It's just whether it's going to be growing or decaying, and that we can determine from the b value. Again, it's still got a domain of all reals, and the range is still from 0 to infinity, not including 0. It's decreasing and continuous everywhere. It still has a horizontal asymptote at the x-axis. Now, because it's decaying, or the graph is decreasing, we call b a decay factor.